So we got the little blue thing. Oh look, it transported us to the front. Oh, whoopee-doo. Shut up, monkey! We're going back.
No, what do we got?
We gotta meet the cats. We gotta return that thing for the kid. We gotta answer that challenge.
Returning that kid's mission?
They return to that kid. We go to the teleporter to get into the front. Oh wait! We can jump back, okay. Warp to port self-entrance and an east entrance.
Delay. Love. I always laugh at that name, that stupid monster tree.
Super killer kid! So we're going to the fishing repeat.
Herbalife. Can't deny me. She's my fine.
My fine! What the frick are you doing, dude? I like how the music stops when he betrays his teammate. That is so funny to me. I'm like, god damn it. Idiot, I swear.
We're back. Where's Videl?
Oh, it's you, Lafayette. I'm sorry, but Videl's already lost consciousness.
But he's still alive, isn't he? Please, let me see him. Videl, it's me.
Whoa, Lafayette. Even his hair changed.
We have all of the ingredients for the Omega Elixir. I'll prove that your translations were correct, Videl. Just wait.
Lafayette.
He's awake.
No, he's just mumbling. That's all he's been saying this whole time.
I'm sorry. Sorry, Lafayette. I'm sorry I told you to go away. I really wanted to talk to you more.
It's fine, really. That doesn't matter now. You're my friend. There's so much of the world you still need to see. You have to get better so we can go on adventures together, okay? Huh? Is that...
It's the Omega Elixir. So it wasn't really a Malak's prayers.
It was their tears.
Sweetheart, you're home.
I am. But I have no right to be here at this point. I chose to do my duty as an exorcist over the welfare of my own dear family. I won't ask for forgiveness. This isn't something that can be forgiven.
Dad?
Videl, are you feeling okay?
He's fine. A generous friend worked hard to prepare the Omega Elixir for him.
The Omega Elixir? Wait, don't tell me your friend is...
You helped him, right? I heard that it was you who told him what the final ingredient was. Thank you, Dad.
No, son. You have no idea. I...
Dad, it's okay. You protected the world in your own way. The one Mom and I live in. The one I want to explore when I get a little older.
Son.
all's well that ends well, hmm?
Hard to believe we managed to actually make an Omega Elixir. That's one hell of an accomplishment.
Oh, and here I was anticipating much wailing and gnashing of teeth. Videl turned out to be pretty resilient, huh?
Can't you just say good job like a normal person?
You're no fun. You did good, kid. Thanks. But I might have given up if not for Velvet's encouragement.
All I did was rile you up. I wouldn't call it encouragement.
Not you too, Velvet.
Anyway, that was a noble thing you did, Luffy said. You really held on to your hope all the way through.
Yeah. I just didn't want to give up on Videl. But I don't really think it's worth praising. I haven't felt lost like you have, Velvet. If I had, I don't think I would have been so sure of myself.
Perhaps. But I think you'll still have it in you. Even if you ever do lose something, dear.
Huh? Why?
That's just the feeling I get. Look, I'm tired of Eleanor's grumbling, so I thought I'd say something nice for once.
Could you not make this my fault?
Because you always say you don't like when people don't say what they say. Look at this, read all these trophies,
What's going on out here?
Yeah, what the hell they kicked us out of this place? Okay. The cat at that place. Interesting. Yeah, why the hell they Oh, I was like, what's she wrong going on crazy for? There it is. It grants one max soul to characters wherein equipment that has been enhanced. Allows the ability to add three random skills to equipment on hard mode. Sure, excuse me. Okay, what's on the map?
City of the Cliffs.
Oh, shit, what was the name of it again? So it forms in bottles. I can't believe that!
Wait, what?
We can teleport by using those bottles. See?
You're funny.
Oh, hello again, Doctor.
Good day. May I order a bouquet? I need it this weekend.
A bouquet? Is it already that time again? You're heading to a ball again this year?
That's right.
A ball?
Same as always. Nico's favorites.
No, I'd like to order lilacs this year.
Lilacs?
I thought I'd tell her the news when I visited this year.
So, you finally decided to marry?
I have. I could never forget Nico. Not a day goes by where I don't think... If only I'd made up my mind sooner with her, then asked her to move here. She wouldn't have been there on that tragic night. And yet, I have to move on.
I think that's the right decision. We can't give up on our lives over those who have left us. We have to live! I'll make the biggest lilac bouquet you've ever seen. I'm sure Nico will be happy for you. And congratulations.
Thank you.
Why a lilac bouquet?
Lilacs have a special meaning. A treasured memory.
I see. I hope his message reaches her.
Yes, I believe it will.
Aww. I wonder what happened to, when he heard they got attacked like that, I wonder what he was doing.
Kitty cat.
And the tavern. Oh, the tavern's that way. Cause then the V was getting here.
I'm finally done cleaning up the house.
This house has plenty of room. We could add more to our family and still be fine.
But that means I'd have to work that much harder, too.
It won't be so bad. As long as we work together as a family, it'll be okay.
Yeah, and Zavid will help out, too.
Yeah, that's right. We always help each other in times of need, just like the way Zavid does.
Aren't you the bossy one? But I hear ya. We'll do it Zavid's way.
Yeah!
I hope Zavid comes over to play soon.
Zavid.
We should ask them how they know him.
Yes, we should. I'll handle it.
He's so nosy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Eleanor Hume, an exorcist with the Abbey. I'm terribly sorry to intrude, but I was hoping you would tell me how you all know Zavid.
Oh, do you know Zavid too?
Yes, we have a history. I was passing by when I just happened to hear his name, and I thought I'd ask.
Oh, sure. Well, we feel like we owe him a great deal. I guess it all started when he kidnapped us.
Kidnapped you?
Let me explain. My wife and I, we were both chefs. And one day, Zavid showed up out of the blue and practically hauled us back to his home.
There, waiting for us, were Theodora and these children.
Theodora?
Yeah, Theodora. You know, his girlfriend.
His girlfriend.
These children had lost their parents, and Zavid and Theodora took them in. Then Zavid rushed us back outside. We were so startled by how sudden it all was. We had no idea what he was going to try to make us do.
But then he asked us if we could cook the children a meal that humans would find delicious. He said that Malakim enjoy eating the same kind of food as humans do, but they lack the skills or know-how to cook it.
At this point, how could we not help? We made them the biggest and best meal we could.
It was huge and delicious. The Mabo curry nearly melted my face off.
The pasta margarita was the best! Well, I love the peach pie!
But yeah, after that, we ended up stopping by the house a lot and started teaching Theodora some recipes.
We lost a child to a demon. Ever since, we've forgotten we could ever laugh. But Zavid, Theodora, and the children, they gave us a newfound joy in life.
From a kidnapper to a savior, then?
Exactly. Until they came along, we'd never even realized that Malakim have hearts, just like people do.
It's because they do that they fight alongside you exorcists against the demons. I see that now.
Right.
What was Theodora like? I love her. When I was too scared to sleep, she held my hand and let me sleep in her bed. She reminded me of my mom.
But Zavid was always so mean to me. One time, he even hit me upside the head.
You two were always roughhousing, being dumb and breaking stuff and getting hurt.
Hey, you wanna fight?
Come on, you two. Calm down.
It sounds like these kids were well loved.
Yeah. But one day, without any warning, Theodora left the house and went missing.
And Zavid went off in search for his love, leaving you two to care for the children.
He asked us to keep the kids safe until he and Theodora returned home.
We just recently moved here, where there's a port. Because our old town was too remote.
All right, I think I get it now. Thank you for sharing your story with us.
Zavid can be a bit rough and tumble, but he's a good man at heart. If he's in trouble, I hope you'll help him out. If not for him, then for the children.
All right.
They were so nosy.
A new recipe! Scout ship.
Excuse me. There's another fan.
People have been saying that the Lord of Calamity destroyed Mercio, but do you know anything about what happened?
Well, Mercio wasn't destroyed. It was more like taken over. All the people were driven out.
How are other towns holding up?
Well, there are more demons around than before. I'd say people are getting nervous.
Is the demon blight really spreading?
It's the worst it's ever been these past few years.
In that case, it's more important than ever that we settle Eastgand.
Eastgand has had the least trouble with the demon blight. More importantly, there's room here for so many to settle.
So, you want to build a new town?
Yeah, I'm thinking of the area around Lake Pernia. It's high up, but it's good land.
Ready access to good fresh water is a big plus. The soil is rich there too, so it'd be a good location for a town.
All right, now I'm getting excited.
Me too. It won't be easy, but in this world, what is? Besides, I want to do my part to help people.
Okay, last thing we'll need is ladies. Can't start a town without our better halves.
Before we plan our town, we'll need to plan for romance.
Don't waste your time.
What?
No woman will fall for a guy who whines about needing love or romance to make something of himself. If you want proof, look no further than the icy glares these ladies here are giving you.
Oh, that scorn. I've never seen anything like it.
Still, it'll be lonely there with just a bunch of guys.
Speak not of dreams. Become them. I read that in a book once. People are drawn to those with conviction, who work hard to fulfill their dreams.
In other words, find passion in something, and someone will take notice of you.
A long time ago, I read that the secret to finding love is not to fall for someone, but to make someone fall for you. Okay, let's do it. Let's make our lakeside town a reality.
Woohoo! The girls won't be able to keep their hands off us.
Oh, goodness. Oh, we already went to that other one.
Theodora, she must be that white-horned dragon, right?
She must be. I don't see any other reason for Zavid to risk his life protecting a dragon.
To be living with human children who have gone through such trauma. The risk of exposure to malevolence would have been high. And yet she was willing to help them. To take them in. It's no wonder Zavid wants to save her.
But there's no way to turn her back into a Malak, right?
That's correct.
Which is why you feel you have to kill it. I don't disagree with your conclusion.
But?
But I think you're going about it the wrong way.
How so?
No one would stand by and permit his former love to be killed before his very eyes. Even when said love has been irrevocably changed. If you could empathize with him and talk things out, I think you two can come to terms without having to fight.
For some things, Eleanor, emotion runs too deep for reason to be heard. If he was so easily swayed that words could convince him, he would already have killed that dragon.
But still...
I'm not in the mood to argue. Let's just go.
If only I could learn how to control those flames.
The flame, baby! What's it telling us? White dragon, white dragon. It sure is working.
I know you guys. I heard you put a real dent in the Exorcist's strength.
I take it you're a Bloodwing? Got any new information for us?
With all the turmoil, there's a lot of noise out there. But I've heard one rumor that stands out. So there was this skilled exorcist praetor at the top of his game, yeah? Apparently, he got taken down by a pinyon.
Oh? And how'd this pinyon supposedly pull that off?
I know it sounds like I'm pulling your leg, but I'm serious! The praetor said the pinyon attacked with arts of earth, water, fire, and
Shit!
The four elements.
That's not all. From what I hear, this pinyon sports red eyes and a golden coat. They call it Goldapin.
All right. So where is this Goldapin?
The attack happened in the Figal ice caps. But I gotta warn you guys, Goldapin is said to be an ominous creature that signals the end of the world. Listen, I'm telling you this for your own good. Whatever you do, you'd better steer clear.
Why would you say that? Oh, now we have to check this out.
So it's a pinyon with red eyes, a gold coat, and control over all four elements? That must mean...
They're calling her Goldapin, huh?
I've seen a lot of things out there, but never anyone who has mastered all four elements. Excluding myself, of course.
Whatever she is, if she's taken down a praetor, she might be willing to work with us.
Or, you know, it could be a trap. This strengthens the case that she could be connected to the four Empyreans.
Either way, we should probably go and find out.
I'll send word to Jude and Isolt.
Hold on. That might complicate the situation.
We promised we'd let him know if we heard anything. I'm just staying true to our word.
Fine. But I have my own way of doing things, too.
Am I missing something? Let's do a kit or something. I'm confused.
There's a steps in the inn. Oh, I thought it was like a steps to go up the inn to go to the balcony.
Okay.
I'm confused.
Announcement. To commemorate all your hard work saving my friends, I'd like to invite you to come to Katz's Corner.
Whoa, Katz's Corner! Awesome!
But we don't have any business there.
Now hold on. Katz's Corner is a sort of phantom place that's never been plotted on any map before.
And we'll have the chance to explore it. If it's home to a lot of cats, I kind of want to see it for myself.
Denied. It's a waste of our time.
Oh, come on, Velvet. Quit being such a killjoy. Katz's Corner is like an exclusive members-only club. Nobody but nobody would turn down an invitation.
Exactly. You should be grateful for this opportunity.
Just think of it as a new experience. Besides, aren't you even a little bit curious?
I can't believe this. You guys are starting to sound more casual than the cats now.
Well, if you ever feel like visiting Katz's Corner, just say the word, meow.
Hell yeah.
Wow, so this is Katz's Corner.
I'd never have guessed a place like this existed.
What an adorable little hamlet. You can feel your motivation to get stuff done just floating away. And look at all the cats!
It's so peaceful here. Kinda makes me want to sit down for a big feast.
Look, over there. Is that the cat's pajamas? I've heard stories.
Oh no! Velvet, don't tell me you're...
Are you allergic to cats? That's why I didn't want to come here.
Are you gonna be okay, Velvet?
Of course, it's not...
Oh, the song is stupid.
The Popro Wrestling BNA World Catnip Cup Tabbyweight title matches tonight, meow. The rules are simple. The contestants knead each other with their paws. The first to make a sound loses or meows out. So, is there, like, a countdown or something? Yep. A purr count starts when one fighter starts purring. Purr for 3 seconds and you're out, meow. Are there any illegal moves? Grabbing the back of the neck and nibbling are both forbidden and incur heavy penalties. It sounds like a lot of fun. I'd love to try it myself. There's going to be an Anything Goes division in the next Agarte Cup. Any race can participate. Just put on a pair of cat ears and you're in, meow.
I've got fervor for adventure. I travel the world to reclaim hidden treasures, meow.
Doesn't that just make you a cat burglar?
Big words coming from a pirate, meow. You guys pilfer and pillage anything you can get your paws on. You prattle on about how romantic your life on the sea is, but you're just a bunch of ruffians.
I'm sorry.
Good. As long as you know where we stand, meow. I've got my own ship, and wait till you hear what I named it. It'll make your whiskers spin. I call her Von Miautia of my youth.
She's like, don't be a hypocrite. Y'all steal Flemish things.
Yeah, there's all the...
Oh, yeah. Get the movies! Okay. Oh my god, this song is stupid.
Tell me I have the hiccups now.
Cats can have different dialects depending on where they were raised, meow. I'm from a small hamlet in the Nyagoya area.
What's unique about your dialect?
She was amazing!
Sorry, I have no idea what you just said.
I said, this fried shrimp is amazing. Cool, huh?
Wow. So how do you say brother in your dialect?
Mjör.
Sister?
Mjör.
Mother?
Mjör.
They all sound the same to me. Can Katz, where you're from, tell the difference?
Of course! It's all about the nuance.
I think it's a bit too much to wrap my head around. Oh yeah, what about father?
Father is father.
Huh? That one's normal.
Meow insulting! Now that it is easy when you meant, you know!
I'm sorry.
I forgive you.
That's very kind of you.
But the proper way to apologize in Nyagoya dialect is you're brave for your forgiveness.
It just sounds like you're a grabber. Oh. Yeah, so evil! Oh, look, we're gonna get me, Lesherita. Lesherita, what was that? Where's that at? Fast travel! Fast travel for the win! So where is it? Wait, is she where that freaking monster was? Cause since she's at the forest craft, she does. She's not at the... Sometimes we're gonna be fighting them together. Why does something tell me that?
Well, if we do, we gotta go out to Mila first.
Look at that, we do, we gotta go out to Mila first.
Well, of course, get the one with the biggest threat out the way.
Look, red eyes? Golden coat? It's Goldapen, all right. And she's even got that... quirk.
Be careful. If what we heard is true, she can use those four great spirits in battle.
See? She's drooling.
Does that mean she thinks we look tasty?
Does that mean she's a man-eating Pengyon?
Wait! Don't fight!
Hey, it's Jude!
No matter how much Mila loves to eat, she'd never attack a person without a good reason. Huh? Wait, this Pengyon isn't Mila?
Are you all right?
When I got your message, I ran all the way here without stopping to eat or drink.
That's enough. When will you people learn to leave this Pengyon alone? Hunting for food, I could understand. But I won't allow you to take this creature's life on some flimsy notion of bad omens.
If you want the Pengyons, you'll have to fight me first!
Running down! Okay. Who the hell are you?
I'm Mila Maxwell, and I'm the protector of Pengyons!
Chica!
Oh, when they let them do like this.
I know.
Like, what?
What?
Oh shit!
sweep away. Water dance and sw- wind be my blade. Earth, my spear. Elements, I call thee.
Elemental mastery!
Oh my god.
You're strong. You know your way around a sword.
As do you. I can see that Jude wasn't exaggerating when he called you the Lord of Spirits.
Jude? Do you know him? I've been looking all over for him.
He's right there.
Oh, Jude! Thank goodness. I'm so glad you're safe.
Mila. You can tell it's me?
Of course I can. You're a lot smaller on the outside, but you're still you on the inside.
Thanks, Mila. That being said, I haven't exactly had an easy time in this form.
Yes, I can see how it might have given you some trouble. Leia and Elise would probably be worried sick, and Alvin would tease you mercilessly.
I think there's a way I can change back. When I fought these guys before, I was somehow able to do it.
You fought them? So they really are a bunch of no-good Pengion abusers.
We're not, I swear. It's all a misunderstanding.
It's okay, Mila. They're the ones who told me where to find you, and they're not Pengion abusers.
Oh, all right then. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go jumping to the wrong conclusions about you.
Everyone, thank you so much for reaching out to me.
No need to thank us. We just did the same as anybody would.
I'm glad you found your friend.
However, both of you are still stuck here.
It's fine. The two of us will figure something out. We'll get Jude back to his normal self, and find our way home to Risa Maxia.
Yeah.
Oh, do you want to come along too?
You know this Pengion?
Yeah, for some reason I've taken quite a liking to him. Something about him just feels familiar.
I suppose so.
They're gone. Is it really okay to let them leave?
What do you say, Aizen? Do you think Mila is connected to the Empyreans?
No. Her arts felt fundamentally different from the ones we Malakim use.
Agreed. I think I might actually believe they came from another world.
In that case, we can let them be. Since she took down that Exorcist, I don't think we need to worry about her joining forces with the Abbey.
Yeah. But couldn't she still join our side?
I wonder. I feel like she might be a bit out of our league.
I don't know. I think you two have more in common than you care to admit.
We should leave them be. Besides, if they came with us, Eleanor might try to eat Jude.
I would not!
Jesus! Holy crap! Then she got an eagle! She got an eagle XP! Holy crap! That lag's P almost to level 70!
Good luck out there.
That was fun. Arena! Oh, glad we don't have to. Can we jump to... Nope, we can't. No. This is it. Like, damn it.
At first I thought she was gonna go all crazy on this and shit.